Traveling party for coming, enlightening and inspiring everybody here. And we're hopeful that it won't be long before we see and have your association here again. So please keep us in mind, give us your blessings, and come to see us and give us your association sometime soon. It's quite a surprise that I was asked to speak something tonight. I'm not necessarily prepared. But all I will say is that what I've heard from my Gurudev is that about how friendly and how important hearing Harikatha, especially from the lips of pure Vaishnavas, are. I think I might have been trying to explain this the first night that Maharaj arrived. Gurudev would tell us that Harikatha is like a very good friend to us. Although we may not appreciate Harikatha so much still, Harikatha is so kind when it's coming from the lips of pure Vaishnavas, that the example is given that a stranger, if he comes to your house, the stranger will knock on the door. And that stranger, he will wait for you to open the door, invite him in, and offer him a seat. A good friend, he will, without being invited, your friend, very close friend, will come, he'll open the door, he'll just answer himself, and if something's on the seat even, he'll move whatever's on the seat and just sit down. So Harikatha coming from the lips of pure Vaishnavas is like this. It'll enter into the ear, even without being invited, and it will come and it will sit on our hearts, if we're very careful, to plug the other ear with Trinada Pisa Nijana Taroa Pisa Hisanada, a mood of humble submissiveness and trying to hear in that way. So again, we think that Harikatha has been a very good friend in coming in the form of Sri Maharaj, and again, we're very grateful. Hare Krishna.
Thank you.
Where is Vera? 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 Where is Vera?
Speak something, even for one moment, by Sikhi Vaishnav, it's mandatory. You should take this into your heart, that the order of Guru Sadhu Shastra, like this, should be something that is obligatory. That if they're giving some instruction, you have to take it upon yourself. Even if feeling lack of qualification, by their mercy, qualification will come. So one thing I've been thinking about during the time Maharaj has been here is that what does sadhu sangha really mean? Not so much that we're enjoying our time here because we have friends. So we come together as a group and then we get to joke together after class and we get to eat. No, we're honoring prasad like this. So in this same way, we should also think that sadhu sangha is not something that we should be thinking it's just for fun, some sort of cordial relationship. It should be that we're coming to serve. So that when we come to see some sadhu, great Vaishnava, like Bhakti Sridhara Maharaj, that we try to engage every aspect of our senses, to some degree, whatever capability we have, in service to this Vaishnava, so that we may catch the attention of this Vaishnava, and then his mercy can come. Like this. In the same way, coming to the temple, not to take darshan, no, to attract Krishna's eye. That we want Krishna to see us. How can we be seen by Krishna? That we must engage in some sort of seva, so Krishna will be looking our direction. Like this, Hey Krishna, Kruna Sindhu, Dina Bandhu Jagapite, Gopesha Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namostute. This is like progression of Krishna's interest in you. Beginning, Krishna is not so interested in his glories. But then when you mention his friends, you mention his gopis, you mention Radharani, now his attention is on you. So in this way, we have to have some eagerness to serve those who are seen for us, and eagerness to serve the community that we are in order to garner the attention of Guru and Sadhu, in order to garner the attention of Krishna, so we can make advancement. So I'm begging that by my service, Srila Bhakti Daksha Kshira Maharaj, that sincerity is invincible. So I'm begging that type of sincerity in my service, so that I'll be blessed by Guru Sadhu Shastra like this, get Bhagavan's favor, and I can make advancement in Krishna consciousness.
Namo Om Vishnu Padaya Radhikai Priyatmane Shri Shriman Bhakti Vedanta Narayana.
Because he never listened to you.
She's not missing anything, don't worry. Namo Om Vishnu Padaya, Krishna Prashtaya, Bhutale, Srimati Bhakti Vedanta Swami Niti Namane, Namaste Saraswati Deve, Gauravani Prajarine, Nirvishesha Sunyavari Pastrutya Deshkarine, Om Ajnana Timanandasya Jnanam Jana Shalakaya Chakshura Meditam Dena Tasmai Sri Guruve Namah. Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhupadananda Shri Advaita Viradhara Shri Vasari Gaura Bhakti Vrinda Vrindaya Kurasa Devaya Priyaya Kisarasa Shri Krishna Bhakti Bari Devi Satya Vachaya Mo Namah Vansha Kaba Trubhya Sakri Basin Vrikshya Vritanam Bhavani Vrilaishna Vrindan Mo Namah Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare. So his Divine Holiness Bhakti Swarup Sridhara Maharaj has asked me to say a few words on this last night in Alachua. We've been traveling since August 4th from Los Angeles through San Jose, San Francisco, New Bridge, Eugene, New York, New Jersey, Alachua, and now on to Miami. All through this tour, Bhakti Sridhara Maharaj has been showering his incredible mercy upon us. Great, great friend. Sent directly by Srila Guru. When I first heard him at Prahlad Prabhu's place in Los Angeles, I could not believe that I was hearing from such a sadhu who perfectly gave us all the teachings that Srila Gurudev had given us. I'd never found anybody that could give all the moods, both of Srila Gurudev and Srila Prabhupada. And I immediately became taken, and I had to tell everybody I knew about him. And we brought him over to the temple in Venice, California. And he spoke on Radhashtami Day. It was the first time he came to the temple, was on Radhashtami Day. And he was like a gift from Srimati Radhikaji. He gave us Radha Tattva. And after that day, all the devotees were walking around like zombies in the garden. They could not believe what they had heard. He had filled in all the gaps that Srila Gurudev had kind of left for him to fill in, and put it in a beautiful packet with a bow and gave it to us and says, "This is Srimati Radhikaji." And ever since then, I've been completely taken by Maharaj. And he's now come to Alachua, and I've just been taken by all the hospitality of all the devotees, and seeing all their tears, and how all of them have taken Maharaj into their hearts. And as Maharaj said, that all you have to do is come and listen. If you simply listen, just do Shravanam, Krishna personally enters through the ear and goes into the heart and cleans everything by himself. There's nothing else that's needed to be done. Just this one quality, just to come and hear. So I just want to thank everybody who have been coming, and I can just see how their atmas have been turned on by Maharaj, and how they've just become so elated. I myself went back to Los Angeles just for a few days. I had to leave the tour. And when we were walked into the house, it's always usually quite jubilant, but it felt like a ghost house. All the deities even looked sad. But where is Maharaj? Where are our glories being spoken? And I had to quickly finish my work to come back here and join him again. And now that I'm back, I'm re-inspired again and want to continue to follow him. He's a very, very special Vaishnava. His Gurudev once said that there was one devotee who was massaging his Gurudev's lotus feet. And his name was Hrishikesh Prabhu. And Srila Bhakti Vaibhav Purnaj told him, "You stop massaging him." He said, "You don't serve me, you serve Bhakti Srivip Sridhar Maharaj." And he said, the reason is because he has all the blessings, the Goswamis. Because the way he speaks about the commentaries, all the Shastras, he's able to pull them from here, there, everywhere. It's not really human how he does this. And he even said, it's not studied. He has all the blessings of the Guru Arjan. And his Gurudev said it is because he has the direct blessings of the six Goswamis. This is why he's able to present like he does. There was also in 2012-2013 in Radhakund, they were building a temple, a very large temple. And they had to do a big installation, and the devotee who was in charge of the installation had to invite all the members of the Gaudiya Math to come and speak. And so all the members of the Gaudiya Math had to choose the chief speaker for the whole Gaudiya Math. And this is all the top Mahabhagavats in the Gaudiya Math. Bhakti Vidyan Bhakti Maharaj, Bhakti Balabhacharya Maharaj, all the great luminaries in Mahabhagavat there. They had to select the chief speaker at this very distinguished program, this installation in Radhakund. And Maharaj was away too. And he did not know, but all of them selected Bhakti Srirup Shiramaj as chief speaker for the Gaudiya Math. So we have one of the best speakers on the planet speaking Bhagavad Gita. And this is all by the great mercy of Srila Bhaktivedanta Narayana Goswami Maharaj, who selected him, and Srila A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada, who made him a devotee. He's always been a devotee, of course, but he came to Prabhupada's gate and then into the vision of Srila Bhakti Bhaktivinoda Maharaj, who made him also. And so to the entire Guru Varga, I thank them from the bottom of the core of my heart for sending such an incredible Vaishnava to help us in our devotion, in our bhakti practice. We couldn't have asked for anyone greater and more loving and sweet. Thank you so much, Maharaj, for coming. Jai.
Srimati Madhaviri, you know this thing, who works. She's very talented.
I didn't listen.
Happiness when he would see his daughter and how she would perform, very qualified from young age, she's the body.
Jnana Timirandasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chakshur Unzitam Vena Tasmai Shri Gurve Namaha Namaham Vishnu Hridaya Radhikaya Priyatmane Shri Srimad Bhakti Vedanta Narayani Tinamane Shri Krishna Lila Katane Sudaksham Adoya Madoya Gunastaitam Parambane Nyam Purusham Mahatam Narayanam Tvam Sirsalamane Manchakopatrupasta, Pipasandu, Vivacha, Patitanam, Pavanibyo, Vaishnavibyo, Namaha. Actually, I'm not so qualified at all, but Gurudev, he gave me one order to speak every day. After 1 week of initiation, he said you should speak every single day. So, even though I'm unqualified for his pleasure, then he can make me a fool in his presence, it's okay. So, one shloka is there in Sri Chaitanya Charitamrita. Sadhu Sangha, Sadhu Sangha, Sarva Sastri Hoi, Lava Macha, Sadhu Sangha, Sarva Sri Hoi. This verse and one other verse, they are saying something three times. The other one is Harinam, 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 Eva Kevalam, Kalo Naseva, Naseva, Gataranyata. So this one, Sadhu Sangha, Sadhu Sangha, Sadhu Sangha. Why three times? Why not one time? Because this Sadhu Sangha is so important. In 1/11th, Lava Mantra means 1/11th of a second. How quick is this? And we're very fortunate, we've had Maharaj here for so many days now. And we've also had the association of our Srila Gurudev and many of you also the association of Srila Prabhupada. But what does it mean, this 1/11th of a second? We're every day. How can we get this Sangha? And it is so powerful that 1/11th of a second, even we don't realize, our whole life is now changed in 1/11th of a second. Why? Because Prema Bhakti Jaha Hoite, coming from the body of a sadhu, is Prema Bhakti. Is the, we feel around different people we meet, we may feel some good feelings or bad feelings when we meet. But this vibes or energy, people will say. But the energy of a pure devotee, their whole body is transcendental. And just 1/11th, one little tiny spark of this Prema Bhakti by associating and getting one little drop of the dust of the dust of the dust, or the spray of the ocean, one little drop of that ocean, connecting into our heart, our whole life is successful. But maybe in that moment we cannot realize. Gurudev, you would say, we're chanting and we're not experiencing. Krishna is not different from his name. We should be experiencing, when we chant this name, we should be experiencing love and affection. Experiencing and seeing Krishna. So we're chanting, but we don't experience. Then there must be one hole in our pot. We are like beggars, but if we are begging and so many holes in our cloth, in our pot, then what happens? Everything is coming through. So we may be in this association for more than 1/11th of a second. We may be 1 week, 1 year, 1 month, so much time. But we are not experiencing because there are some problems. Gurudev said we should check our pulse and see where is the defect. The defect is not in bhakti. The defect is not in the sadhu. The defect is in our own hearts. And as the sadhu is saying and giving instruction, then we should take to heart, how is this Vaishnava, how is Gurudev, how is he telling us to practice? What is every day he's telling us to do? Then if we are practicing and following, then we can begin to experience this love of matcha, this 1/11th of a second, we can actually experience what it is to be in the company of a sadhu. And also, Nishchinga Prabhu, he's saying, doing some seva. Because coming, not just coming, oh, I will see sadhu, I will go, I will be there. No, how can I serve? How can I do something that will melt the hearts of the Vaishnava? So by hook, by crook, by any way, any tricky way, even one story of, you can correct me, Maharaj, if I'm wrong, but Narottam Das Kapoor and Lokanath Das Goswami. There, Lokanath Das Goswami is pushing Narottam Das Thakur away. I will not give you initiation. I'm not taking disciples. So then very trickily, Narottam Das Thakur, he went to the place where Lokanath Das Goswami would pass stool. How many of us would go to the place where anyone passes stool to clean? Voluntarily, eagerly, happily. But this Narottam Das Thakur, so much greed in his heart for the mercy of the Vaishnava, then every day, in secret, after Lokanath Das Goswami is leaving, he's going and cleaning this area. And after some time, then Lokanath Das Goswami, his heart begins to melt, and he's giving this initiation to Narottam Das Thakur. So we are all sitting here hearing this Harikatha, but we should also think, how can we serve this Harikatha? How can we serve the Vaishnavas? How can we serve our Gurudev? And so many opportunities here in Alachua. And if not in Alachua, then we have Harinam. We can serve Harinam. We can serve Harikatha. We can serve Thakurji. So many ways. So we are so fortunate here. And I feel very blessed that Maharaj has come knocking on our door in our house without any invitation from me personally, just now coming and speaking. So my heart is also very hard, like one coal. But day after day listening, then some small stirring is coming and remembering my Gurudev's Harikatha and feeling some nourishment there. So I just ask for all the Vaishnavas if they can give some blessings that I can also engage in serving sadhu Vaishnavas, and also Maharaj, if you can give some blessings that I can please my Gurudev and Vaishnavas also. Thank you.
I was meditating on what the presence of Maharaj actually means, you know, in just coming here and on our lives and everything. It is pretty significant, and I know everyone can feel it. I know I do feel it. But one thing I learned from the Vaishnava was, you know, studying Java Dharma with Prangavinda Prabhu for so many years, that we cannot really see a Vaishnava just by our senses. Our senses are so dull and so, like, we're not perfect, you know what I mean? Who is perfect here? No, okay. So our senses are very imperfect. So sometimes we might see a Vaishnava or someone who's speaking very eloquent and think, oh, what a great Vaishnava, how amazing he's speaking and stuff. You know, so we have to see the Vaishnava through Shastra, you know. How the when he speaks, if he's aligned with Guru Varga, if he's speaking the scriptures, what we heard so many years from Gurudev, you know? And there's no doubt about it that Maharaji is speaking that. He's so aligned with our Guru Varga, our Gurudev, Goswami Maharaj, and also the scriptures. He knows the scriptures back and forward, you know? It's not like he's memorizing something, you know? It's actually coming from the heart, you know? You can see, sometimes you just close his eyes and remember something so easy, because he's praying, you know? To the Lord, to that verse, he's praying to that Shastra, you know? And to find someone like that in this world is very rare. So we should be very lucky and fortunate that Maharaj is coming here, you know? I don't know if so many of you experienced, but when the first time I met Maharaj, when he came last year here, I just felt like Gurudev just walked into the room again. You know, as soon as he started speaking, it was just everybody was crying, you know? It was just humility. And also, I know Maharaj doesn't like to hear some glorifications, but we have to, because it's the last day, so, you know, we have to give some sweet words to the Vaishnavas when they come. It also, it's part of our, you know, part of our Vaishnava behavior, you know, to speak some sweet words to the Vaishnavas, you know. I know Vaishnavas don't really like to hear their own glorifications, but we must do it for our own benefit. So, also, one of the qualities, the Maharaj is so, like, everyone's so attracted to Maharaj is his humility, you know? He's so humble. sorry, Maharaj, I'm on the stage. But he's just so humble that he melts the heart of everyone, you know? Just by his humility, you know? So many people might have so many doubts at the beginning, but when Maharaj starts speaking, all those doubts just melt out, you know? Because his Harikatha is so powerful. He has received the blessings of our Guru Varga, you know? Even people from Ustream, they're not even here and they're listening to Maharaj and they get inspired, you know? Not even just the person who's listening, you know, the person who's just walking around the Ustream going on, that person is getting so much benefit too, you know? I know one person at least here that came from the Ustream. I'm very happy that he's here, you know? So it's really amazing. This Harikatha is just so amazing. And also like this beautiful couple here, Raiden and Clary? Carly and Raiden. They came all the way from California following Maharaj, you know? How amazing that is, you know? Sometimes...
We follow them also.
Yeah, exactly. We follow how enthusiastic they are, you know? I wish I had their enthusiasm, like, because they're hearing this and this is something new for them. They're so enthusiastic, you know. But I was born into this movement, so I take it for granted sometimes, the enthusiasm, you know. So it's so nice to see, you know, you're coming all the way from, you didn't even know what the philosophy is. You just heard a few things and you're like, wow, that sounds interesting. Let's go, you know. This is just so amazing. I mean, I wish I could do that, you know. No, but I have to be convinced and this and that, because my head is so huge and my heart is like a stone, so I have to hear Siddhanta all day long to actually get something, you know? But their heart is already kind of soft and they're so easy for them to just accept something, you know? So, but Maharaj has that power to melt your heart, you know? It's just like, he gave me like, he's like so like, comes down to my level, you know, in the sense of like he can talk to me so easily and just tell me, oh yes, Arjuna, this year I will tell something. Maharaj will smile like he's just a friend, but it's, you know, he's such a high Vaishnava, you know, and this is how Shiksha Guru is, you know. He becomes really your friend, like bosom friends, you know. So we're so fortunate. We cannot really realize how fortunate we are right now. But a few years from now, we will be like, oh my God, how did not see it before, you know?
Tomorrow.
It's like tomorrow we all be crying. Tomorrow's day. You know? Anyways, I don't want to take so much time because we all want to hear from Maharaj, but I just want to thank you, Maharaj, for coming again. Please come again and we'll be praying. Like you said one day, if you pray to Krishna, then Krishna will arrange that I will come again. So we'll pray to Guru Varga and Krishna, and you'll come back again. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Jnana-tinirandasya jnananjana-sravakaya Chakshurum yanitam yena tasmai sri gurve namaha Mukham karoti vachalam pangum langayate girim Yat kripa tamaham vande sri guru tinatarine Gurve gaura chandraya radhikayai taralayai Krishnaya Krishna Bhaktaya Tadabhaktaya Namo Namaha Sri Chaitanya Manobhistam Stapitam Yena Bhutale Sayam Rupa Kadamayam Dadati Svapadatikam Anarpita Charinchirat Karanaya Vatirna Kadao Samarpaitu Unaka Uchkalarasam Svabhakti Sriya Harihara Kriyata Sundara Jyotikadam Vasanti Pitaha Sadari Dayai Kandares Puratu Vasachinantadam Vanchya Kalpa Karubhyasya Kripa Sindhu Vaivacha Patitana Pavanetyo Vaishnavetyo Namo Namaha Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama, Rama Rama, Hare. We all want to hear from Maharaj this evening, last evening, but it is important that we hear from each other also in presence of Sri Gurudev, Srila Prabhupada, Sri Sridhara Maharaja, Sachinanda Gaura Hari, all Nityananda Prabhu. All are there, why they are there? To bless us, so that we become theirs only. One devotee asked me yesterday, Rajanath Prabhu, now you are traveling, I'm here in with Pujyapad Bhakti Svarup Sridhara Maharaj. I said, I don't know what I'm doing, but I only know that my good fortune is to have that beautiful association. Then he said, what is your experience in regards to traveling with Gurudev? Then I was thinking and then praying what I should tell. Because whenever I tell anything, some people may not be happy to hear. Others may be happy, but what can I do? What if Gurudev? Gurudev wants to use all of us as this little instrument, and we should know that in our heart we should not keep any malice for anyone. Do not disrespect anyone, not even ordinary living entities. This is teaching about Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, God Himself, I want to speak those who are practicing Krishna Bhakti. There may be some confusion time to time amongst us, but we are family. And Gurudev always said, don't criticize anyone. But neither devotees in ISKCON, no one you should criticize. Because we are one family. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, all are His children. Like Arjuna Prabhu said, we are not perfect. So when we are not perfect, we may sometimes feel a little displeased with each other. But in our heart, we should keep no malice. Don't criticize. Respect everyone because all are making progress. All who have faith in Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, all who have faith in Nityananda Prabhu, they are progressing. Even those, Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur says, who have faith in God, they are also progressing. Christians, anyone, we should not criticize. Disrespect them. Always be kind to all living entities. This is one of the responsibilities of devotees, Vaishnavas, be kind to all. Now how can we be kind to all only when we are happy? Isn't it? If you're unhappy, then even the person who is most near and dear to you, you may be annoyed with that person. So we should try to make some deep search in our heart, what brings happiness to us. Only one thing brings happiness if we please Sri Gurudev. If we please our Guru Parampara. That means we will please Krishna. We do not know who is Krishna. What Gurudev? He is near and dear. He is intimate associate, Vrajavasi, directly, always engaged 24 hours a day in Krishna service. So we try to bring happiness to him. Happiness towards Gurudev means we help each other to progress in bhakti. And we help all those who are completely bereft of the true information how to be happy. Like devotees who are doing the book distribution, who are distributing the message to the world, the devotees who are forgotten completely, identifying themselves with the body. This is such a beautiful service. And then Gurudev explains, we do everything only for the pleasure of Guru and Vaishnavas. So here, we are all assembled. What is the proof that we are progressing? The proof is Gurudev said, how do you know that your Gurudev is pleased with you? You will be very happy. And you will have no tendency to disrespect anyone. That means Gurudev is present. That means Gurudev's mercy is coming. So we are so lucky that with the help of our entire Guru Parampara, we have heard that any Vaishnava who has received the blessings of the Guru Parampara, that Vaishnava is very, very valuable. So how Maharaji has come in our lives, it is by their blessings, by their mercy. Even whatever we do, if we do not carefully analyze, then we will not understand that actually Gurudev, if anything we can do which is favorable, it is His mercy. By His mercy, we are sitting here in presence of Pakuji, in His presence, to become more inspired to bring happiness to Gurudev. So how lucky we are that we are here, becoming more and more happy every day. And please, my request is, remember the golden instructions of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself, which are the secret of being in harmony with our whole family. Yeah. One time they asked Gurudev here in Miami, how your mission will be successful? The Guru Maharaj replied, that all my devotees, especially sannyasis and preachers, are Trinad Ati Sunichena. Taro Nida Srishna. Amanina Manadena Kirtanya Sadhavani. They have no any desire to have anything for themselves. They don't want followers. They don't want position. They don't want money, house, anything. Yeah. Their own prestige. Only they want to give the wealth of their heart and respect all. Yeah. Then he said, my mission will be successful. So I'll conclude here with the devotee who asked me yesterday, what is your experience being with Maharaj? Yeah. In regards to being with Srila Gurudev. So I wrote him that, same wine, new bottle. Yeah. Same wine, new bottle. Yeah. The wine tastes exactly the same. Externally, we might think, oh, this is a young bottle. Yeah. Small bottle. But really, this is the conclusion. Yeah. And we want that all our senior Vaishnavas, because many of them have received immense mercy and blessings from our Guru Varga, that they should all wake up if they are not already awake. That they should unite. And together with Maharaj's kindness, his inspiration, he has expressed desire to help all Gurudev's followers, not only Gurudev's followers, all devotees to be united in harmony and happy, serving the order, the mission, the teachings, the desire, especially the innermost desire of our Guru Varga. What is that innermost desire? That we are ready to do anything. Like Mahavidhi expressed, Gurudev said, if we are ready to do anything, anyone who may speak very eloquently, and he may attract whole crowd, And he like chants so many rounds. Guru Nanak said, if we see another devotee who is cleaning the stool of any Vaishnava, or of Gurudev, he said, who is more object of mercy? Someone who is ready to do anything in order to please the Vaishnavas. If our mood by anything we do is not for that pleasure, then we have no real inner connection. So deeply we should always meditate. Oh Maharaj, he is helping us. I was wondering after Gurudev's departure what we have received. We have received like same story, everything, but how to apply it? Who will help us put the parts together and go indeed search for where I am? Who will come to? Who will be so kind to? Who will be so loving and affectionate to come to my level and help me move, make my next step? So Gurudev, I pray to you that please send your representative, send your associates, send your kind followers to help us to continue. So I am truly amazed. Gurudev predicted to me, he said, you have no idea what will happen in the future. And it is true, we have no idea. We can only look at the past. Yeah. If we want to see the future, we think, what happened in the past? Maybe something like that will happen. Yeah. But what will exactly happen, we have no idea. So I want to invite all of us who are present here, who are listening in your stream, that don't hold any grudges for anyone. Don't disrespect each other. But be careful to only focus upon that area which is supremely blissful and beneficial for us. And that is, go there where we can hear sublime Harikatha. We have heard how Harikatha is our best friend. Best friend comes in your house and he starts cleaning everything. So this is our greatest fortune, that the carriers of that Harikatha, they are the greatest donors and well-wishers. Later on we will come in that other category, which we have heard explained by Maharaj. But we should see, this is our real fortune, that we can have that type of association. And then our opportunity is to distribute that Harikatha. Then really we have understood the inner meaning of the desire of our Guru Varga. The Brihad Mardanga, to distribute the teachings, to distribute the good news.
Yeah.
So all of us have now golden opportunity to become more connected with our Guru Varga and to help each other to please all sincere devotees and all living entities in the universe. So Srila Bhakti Vedanta Swami Maharaj Srila Prabhupada ki jai, Srila Bhakti Vaibhava Puri Goswami Maharaj ki jai, Srila Gurudev ki jai, His Holiness Sripad Bhakti Swarup Sridhara Maharaj ki jai. All glories to the assembled devotees. Vancha Kautaka Rupya Sakti Bhakti Tadeva Japatita Rupala Nibhya Vaishnu Nibhya
Vibhag Bhajanastra Uki. Namasrishtham Manumati Sachiputramatra Svarupam Rupam Tasya Grajamurupurim Mathurim Goshogatim Radha Kundam Girivaramahu Radhika Madhavasam Prapto Jasya Prakita Kripaya Sri Gurum Tam Natosmi Namom Vishnum Padaya Krishna Prishthaya Bhutale Srimate Bhakti Vaibhava Puri Goswami Namini. Namo Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prasthaya Bhutale Srimate Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Tinamini Bhajanu Lambita Bhujo Tanaka Padato Sankirtanai Kapitaro Kamalayatacho Vishvambharo Dvijavaro Jugadharma Palo Vande Jagatriyakaro Karuna Avataro Hilo Dhulita Khedaya Visadaya Prunmila Damodaya Samya Sastra Vibadaya Rasadaya Chitarpitonmadaya Sasvad Bhakti Vinondaya Samadaya Madhurya Marjadaya Sri Chaitanya Daya Nibheta Vadaya Bhuyadamandodaya Tasya Apara Rasasara Vilasamurte Rananda Kanda Paramadhuta Saukhya Lakmya Brahma Lidurgamagati Vrishabhanujaya Kainkarja meva mama janmani janmani syat Jo brahma rudra sukha narada bhishma mukhyai Ralakhito na sahasa purushasya tasya Satyo vasikarana churnam ananta saktim Tam radhika charana renu manu smarami Ha devi kaku bharagad gadayadya vacha Jache nipatya bhuvidandavata udvatati Asya prasadam abudhasya janasya kritva Gandharvike nijagane gananam videhi Tavaivasmi najivami kvaya vina Iti vijnaya radhitvam Nayamam charanantikam Radhe Vrindavanadhi se Karuna Amritavahini Kripaya Tava Padabje Dasyam Mayam Pradiyatam E Deva He Daita He Bhuvanai Kavandho He Krishna He Chapala He Karunai Kasindho He Natha He Ramana He Nayanam Hirama Aha Kadanu Bhavitasi Padam Vrusodne Nilachala Nivasaya Nityaya Paramatmane Balabhadra Subhadrajyam Jagannathayate Namaha Sri Jagannatha Niladri Siro Mukutaratnahe Daru Brahman Dhanasyama Prasida Purusottama Bhaktya Vihina Aparadha Lakshai Kiptasya Kama Ditaranga Madhi Kripa Maitvam Saranam Prapanna Vrinde Namaste Charana Ravindam Yam Pravajantam Anupetam Apeta Krityam Vaipayano Virahakataraajuhava Putreti Tanmayataya Taravo Vinedu Tam Sarva Bhuta Hridayam Munimanatosmi Narayanam Namaskritya Naram Chaiva Narutamam Devim Sarasvatim Vyasam Tato Jaya Mudirai Tamadidevam Karunanidhanam Tamalavarnam Suhitavataram Apara Sansara Samudra Setum Bhajamahe Bhagavata Svarupam Vancha Kalpa Tarubhyascha Kripa Sindhubhya Evacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavebhyo Namo Namah Jaya Rupa Sanatana Bhattarabhunaha Sriviva Gopala Bhatta Dasarabhunaha Adadanam Trunam Dantai Idam Jate Puna Puna Sri Madrupa Padam Bhoja Dhulisyam Janma Janmani Sri Chaitanya Manobhisham Sthapitam Dena Bhutale Soyam Rupa Kadamayam Dadati Svapadantikam Jaya Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhara Srivasadi Gaur Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare Hare Hare
Shri Srimad Bhakti Vaibhava Puri Goswami Maharaj and pray his causelessness. Then I offer my innumerable Sashtang Dandavas unto the lotus feet of his divine grace Nithyala Pranishta Om Vishnupada Ashtotra Sata Shri Srimad Bhakti Vedanta Narayana Goswami Maharaj and pray his causelessness. Then I offer my innumerable Sashtang Dandavas unto the lotus feet of His Divine Grace Nityala Pranishta Om Vishnupad Ashtotra Sata Sri Srimad A.C. Bhakti Vedanta Swami Maharaj Srila Prabhupada and pray His causeless mercy. Then I offer my innumerable Sashtang Dandavas unto the lotus feet of His Divine Grace Nityala Pranishta Om Vishnupad Ashtotra Sata Sri Srimad Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada and pray his causeless mercy. Then I offer my innumerable Sashtang Dandavas unto the lotus feet of all Guru Vardas, Guru Parampara and pray their causeless mercy. Then I offer my innumerable Sashtang Dandavas unto the lotus feet of Sripad Jairishi Prabhu, Sripad Omkar Prabhu, Sripad Bhradanath Prabhu, Indupati Prabhu, Lakshmipati Prabhu, Gaur Sundara Prabhu, Shyam Sundara Prabhu, then to all Narasimha Prabhu, then to all present Vaishnavas, Vaishnavis, devotees, and pray the godlessness of God. Today is the last class. Then Svarupa mode will come tomorrow. We started from what is the greatest suffering, now coming from tomorrow. Yeah. Really, in Alachua, very nice devotees are. That's why devotees are here in this place. His heart is not clear, he cannot make you happy. And I do nothing. I am just instruments of our Guru Bhargava. Especially Gurudev, Narayana Vaishnava, A.C. Bhakti and Saint Prabhupada, with whom I more witness. And from beginning, I told that Bhagavad Gita, blessed A.C. Bhakti and Saint Prabhupada, then Guru Maharaj, then Narayana Vaishnava, the associated. So, all of them, they are my Sikha Gurus all. From them I learned everything. And not only learning, by their blessing I got all. Really I do nothing. They are inspiring and manifesting. I have no credit at all. Why? Lord Krishna what he told on Bhagavad Gita. Matahas sarvasya cham bhuti sannivishta. Matah Sprunti Janam Apohanam Cha Vedeshi Sarvai Ahamaiva Vidya Vedantakur Veda Videva Chaham Sarvasya Cham Vrudhi Sannivishta. Means I am present in the core of heart of every living entity. This is the meaning of Sarvasya Cham Vrudhi. Who is he? Krishna is sitting where? In the heart, not in the body. Hridi means Hridaya, means heart. So Lord Krishna said in Bhagavad Gita, Sarvasya Chaham Hridi Sannivishta. I am present in the core of heart of every living entity. Unless I present, no one can remember me. Mataha Sprunting. Because I am present, so everyone is living. Remember. If I will give up the body, no one can. If soul is there also, no one can remember me. Mataha, if I present also, if I present also, no one can remember. Don't think if Krishna is present, you can remember nothing. Krishna is present in everyone, but all are not remembered. Why? Mataha Sprunti, to whom I will bless, only he can remember. Really, jiva do nothing. Only doing the arrogance, nothing. He is doing one thing, that is arrogance. That I did. But really, no one did. Only Krishna doing everything. Mataha. Krishna said, Mataha, by my blessing. To whom I will bless? Smriti, he can remember. And Mata Smriti Apahana. And to whom I will not bless, he cannot remember. If he tries, he cannot remember. So here Mata means Krishna does not mean Krishna Upalakram. Means here Upalakram means not myself. By Madhyam means my beloved devotees like Gurudev, Vaishnavas. If Gurudev, Vaishnavas and myself, if we bless, then only one can remember. If we have no blessing, if one tries, we cannot remember. Mata Sprunti Apahana. Sprunti Apahana. Means I will take out the memory also, unless I can. Then nobody can listen. He can read 24 hours a day, he cannot speak single word. Unless blessing is there. This is the proof in Bhagavad Gita. Krishna and in Krishna's own word, which who cannot refute it. Because no one is more than Krishna in this world. Only?
Yes, now goes on the same. Yes, now goes on the same. Yes. So Radha is special mercy now goes on the same. Yes.
First time you came, you spoke Radha Tapa.
Yes, so, yes, he remembers. So it is in his heart till now. Every, it is forever. He cannot forget. That's why nobody replied, but he replied. Yes. Because in this material no one is great personality. More than Krishna, no one.
Krishna is asamartha tattva. Krishna in Sanskrit, Krishna is asamartha tattva. What is the meaning of Abhay Prabhu?
I've heard that a means without, sama means equal, and urdhva means above. So he who is without, equal or above, this is Krishna.
Means asamardhva. Na sama urdhvam ca jasya sa asamardhva. One who is not equal to Krishna. Who is not equal to Krishna? What to speak about superior to Krishna? Na sama. Sama means no one is equal to Krishna. If no one is equal to Krishna, what to speak about superior to Krishna? Impossible. All are Krishnas, ekala ishvara Krishna, ars of nitya. Jake, jekchen, nachan, techen, karan, nitya. Only ishvara is Krishna. Supreme Person of Godhead is Krishna. Ars of nitya, all of them, without Krishna, all others are vritya, servants. No one is master. Master is only Krishna. Jaka jaisen natayin taishan kar vritya. Krishna, to whom, how one to play, he is playing like that. All control is under Krishna. Because only master is Krishna, no, so many masters. All are authorized masters by him. But original master is Krishna himself. But still, his mastership is going on. By who? Yeah. Why? Because Krishna loves more, extremely to others. That's why he is able to do this. Because no one can attract more to Krishna than Radharani. Why? Radharani is loving to Krishna extremely. No one's love is equal with Radharani. So, if now we concluded, if Krishna only pleases and wants to bless, then only one can remember. If Krishna does not bless, does not want, then no one can remember. Why? He said in the opposite also. Matta Smriti Apavana. Means if I don't bless, then Smriti means whatever he has memory, everything will go away. He cannot remember. He may study 24 hours a day, cannot remember one sentence. But if I bless, no need of studying also, he can remember everything. Bless example, Dhruva Maharaj. He did not study, he has no single book. He was in forest, in Madhuban, Mathura. Dhruva Tila you have seen in Brother Mandal Parikrama. Dhruva Tila. There he was chanting the mantra, Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. So he did not, he had no scripture, only mantra of his Gurudev, Devarsinarada, and his blessing. When Narada blessed, Krishna is bound to bless. So blessing was there. So without school, going to school, college, without studying scripture also, he could able to recite the verses. How many verses recited by Dhruva Maharaj to Lord Vishwakshan, Lord Prasinga? You know? Dhruva Maharaj when saw to Lord Prasinga, he recited by prayer. Try to please him. How many verses? 12 verses. And within 12 verses, you will find all revealed scriptures as convention. Yes, that is why nowadays, if you bring a greatest learned professor of whole world, then also he cannot explain clearly one verse of Dhruva Maharaj. So deep meaning inside, in each verse. Where from it? It came from blessing. So, professors are unable to understand this, in each verse. But Dhruva Maharaj is able to understand this. Why? By thoughts of Krishna's counsel. Then counsel is significant of Veda. So that is why we should listen always counsel. That is why after arati, counsel is compulsory to sing. Some places not singing it is not proper. The sound of counsel is auspicious. Sound of counsel is auspicious and after end of the arati, one is bound to compulsory sing. Blow the counsel. It is the etiquette and rule of scripture. Because listening the sound of counsel is auspicious to whole world. Why? Counsel is manifestation of transcendental knowledge of Vedanta. So don't think this sound, this is transcendental sound. Don't consider consciousness is ordinary. Krishna is keeping always with him, consciousness. Like tulasi plant, all the looking we hear in this material world, it is not a material plant. Tulasi is transcendental. All the looking like in the category of ordinary plant. Tulasi is not manifesting like transcendental, looking like ordinary plant. But if we think ordinary plant, offense. We cannot avail the profit. We cannot take the advantage of and blessing. Although looking like small plant and tulasi is all symptom also like ordinary small plant. If you did not take a little, it immediately disappear. Like ordinary, not showing the prayer, not showing the power that I am no need of help of anyone. Tulasi plant also needs help. If you know proper care, it will disappear. So not showing any power of it, but still transcendental. If one is very devoted, with sincerity to serve, then all power will maintain. That by Tulasi's blessing, one can get devoted. Without Tulasi, one cannot get devoted. If you offer anything without Tulasi, Krishna will not receive anything. Not to speak about it, giving the blessing. So Tulasi is very significant. Rupa Goswami explained in Bhakti Rasamrita is significant. About Tulasi, many glories. Yes. So, if Gurudev, Vaishnavas, Krishna will not bless, no one can do anything. That is why, without blessing, no one can do anything. Or, like you see, when the bow was in the hand of Arjuna, and he was pulling the string, three worlds were trembling. So powerful. As long as Arjuna's hand was attached with Bhav Gandhi, three worlds were trembling. No one is able to come in front of him. Even Arjuna was surprised to Lord Shiva. Lord Shiva wanted to test how powerful Arjuna is, how intelligent in the fighting of Bhav and arrow. Lord Shiva wanted to test him. But Arjuna found in such a way that Shiva pleased him. And by his fitness and quality, Lord Shiva gave one arrow also, Ashvatastra. So Arjuna is so powerful. But for why? What for? Due to Krishna's blessing. As long as Krishna was present with him, then only this Gandhi was working. It does not mean that Arjuna was doing. How it is proved? When Krishna disappeared, and Arjuna was, after disappearance, Arjuna was returning from Dwaraka to Hastinapur. At that time on the way, Arjuna could not lift the bow. The bow he was feeling so heavy that he was bound to put on the head. But before that, very easily he was taking it. What to speak lifting? He broke in the assembly of many kings in the palace of Drupad Maharaj, King Drupad. He broke the very powerful bow and got Draupadi. So powerful. And he defeated many warriors in the Mahabharata fighting. And same Arjuna is present. Same Gandhi was present. But that power is not present. Means really who was he? We should know all this. Unless we realize this, then only arrogance comes. A real learned scholar will have no arrogance. Who is becoming arrogant? Who does not know? Really only showing arrogance. He is there. Real learned scholar or real sadhu, real intelligent person will have no arrogance. Because he knows how he will arrogance will come. Automatically he will become humble. But those who are really ignorant and thought that we are the superior, etc., they are arrogant. Why? If you go deeply, we do nothing. Everything is done by Krishna and his devotees, by their blessing. The example is Arjuna. Arjuna had Gandhi, and same Arjuna was present, but Krishna was no more present, because he disappeared. When he disappeared, Same Arjuna, same Gandhi, not working anymore. What to speak, fight with the others. This Arjuna was unable to lift the bow by hand. So it was feeling too heavy that he put on the head. And by putting on the head, he went to Hastinapur. Then he expressed his inability in front of his eldest brother, Yudhishthira Maharaja. Vanchitoham Maharaja Harina Bandhurupina. Arjuna's first word. After disappearance of Krishna, in sorrowful mood, when in gloomy mood, very distressed condition, when he returned from Dwarka to Hastinapur and met first time to his eldest brother Yudhishthira Maharaj, he expressed his feeling. Because Arjuna was unable to speak single word also. But Yudhishthira was requested again and again, then he was bound to speak. That is big story in Bhagavatam, it is not in Mahabharata. In Bhagavatam, that his first word came, Banchitoham Maharaja Bandhuna Harina Bandhuru. Means I became bereft of my dear most friend, who was my friend, and who was God Himself, who was my friend, who was my everything. I became bereft of him. So I have nothing anymore. I don't feel anything anymore. So I am unable to wash myself. I am unable to lift the Gandhi, what to speak to other things. So I felt myself now, who was doing this? My friend, Krishna was doing this. So if we feel like this, we will have no error. And when we feel this, then blessing will come. Otherwise, no worthy of accepting the blessing. So really we do nothing. Everything is this listening and speaking going on by the blessings of Gurudev, Guru Parampara and Lord Krishna, Mahaprabhu Radhanya. In using I spoke about this. What is Srimad Bhagavat Katha? All of you are present, but you are not present. So how this Katha is manifesting? Yes. Today you know. She can speak you later on. But I thought today she is leaving. Yeah. So here also for the 1 week or a whole month beginning from 4th till today according to Gaurasundar Prabhu said, the beginning of 4th August from LA. Till now, what is going on? All are being done by Gurudev, Guru Parampara, Vaishnavas, Krishna and everyone. We are just object of this service. We are very fortunate that they chose to make us object of service. This is our good fortune. Otherwise, all credit should go to them. We are not the receiver of credit. We are only receiver of blessing. We are not the receiver of credit. When you want to receive the credit, then you will lose everything. Only we are receiver of blessings, not receiver of credit. Credit should go to, that is why Sri Sri Guru Gauranga was there. All credit should go to Guru Gauranga Krishna, Vaishnava. So we are only qualified to receive one thing, that is blessing. If blessing is with us, everything is perfect. So everything will be successful. So without blessing, we cannot do anything. So we should try to get blessings. So what topic you will start already? 9 o'clock, 6:50. Start
topic?
Where is your secretary? He's
back side now. Oh. He lost his power.
Yeah. He said, now no power. So we will start a little past time?
Yes.
Huh?
Yes.
Okay. So, concluding my lecture about this. So we were discussing before till Nandotsav. After that we stopped. Then after that what did happen, we will discuss. Yeah. We did not listen what conscious condition was after that. After that we entered in Gokul. But after that what did happen? Conscious tension started. Why? That Jagamaya, to whom he was going to kill on the stone, then she slept sleepily and went to the sky and recited one word. What is that, you know?
Oh, fool.
Yeah. Oh, fool. King Maya Hatena Manda. Oh Manda. Oh stupid. Oh evil. Also, what is the value of killing me? You cannot kill me, else I know. But what is the value of killing me? Please try to find out who is your killer. Already he has appeared and took birth. After listening this, my enemy already took birth, I could not know. Then she told, yes, you are a fool, how you can know? Just you try to know, then only you can, maybe. After that, she disappeared. And now conscious tension started. She is now in full of tension, 24 hours then no sleep, no eating properly. Why? I will die. Where is my enemy? Then how to know? Then he called a meeting. Janur, Musti, Khala, Tosol, Kutta, all his ministers, who were very powerful. So he called a meeting. In that meeting, he asked, what to do, you tell me? Because I had arranged very big security in my jail, but still, how he left, you could not know. All of you are a fool also. Because if I am also a fool. Why? Because Narada said me I am fool. Yes, also. I am also fool. Because Narada said me fool. Yes, Yoga Maya also told me I am fool. And now I proved that all of you are also fool. Because if master is fool, how servants can be intelligent? Because all of your master myself, but I proved myself as fool, how you can be intelligent. So whatever happened, but now we should be careful. We should not become any more fool. We should be intelligent. Then Sanur Musti asked her, how, what to do? Kansa said, that is why I called you. What to do? Now you tell me what to do. Because this Devi, who was in the sky, she said that my enemy somewhere took birth. So how will catch him and kill? Because unless I kill him, then I will die. So you have to all, it is your duty that to search him and kill. How to do? Because it is very difficult to know where is he now. Then Chanur said, Maharaj, Kansa, don't be worried. I got one knowledge that how he will be killed. Then Kansa asked, how? When this ball or Devi told to you tonight, or early in the morning. Then if she told today that when appeared, then she told recently. Oh, recently then we have no problem. We will kill all the children.
Just born,
not only today. Because if there is some doubt, maybe appeared before, so we will kill 10 days, within 10 days, who took birth. If you have some more doubt also, within 1 month also, we'll kill everyone. Oh. So that there will be no doubt at all. First 10 days before, who appeared, they are prominent. And if there is some doubt also, we'll kill within 1 month who appeared or took birth, we'll kill everyone. Then there will be no problem to you. Then Kansa said, Chano, it is okay, but I think you are not intelligent. It may be working, but it is not intelligent. Why? Because if you do like this, whole kingdom, all citizens will be against you. Why? Because you are killing to everyone. You don't know who is your enemy. And you will kill everyone to innocent child also. Then we will lose our post. No one, personally. No other respect. No one will appreciate us. This is, I think, no bona fide process. But if you want, you can try. If there's problem, then we will stop this. So they tried. They tried. After that, many people became very against to Kansa. So when he got the news from everywhere that Kansa is cruel, Kansa is bad king, etc., then he stopped this again. This is not working. Then he called again second meeting. Then Chanur Musti, they all came. Then Kansa said, before I, at the beginning, I said that it is not bona fide process to kill. Now a very big bad name and blaspheming is going on in the Mathura. So better you stop this process. You try to find different process. Okay, who is very intelligent, he can speak this. Then always speculating what to do, what to do, what to do. In that assembly,